What's up, my pretty people? It's your girl, Pretty Girl This, and I'm back with another video. Make sure you like, comment, subscribe, and hit that notification bell. Y'all gotta come back. You see, in my previous video, I was in the hospital, but I had to come back and make a story time about this situation. Because, you know, I don't have to tell y'all, but I feel like me speaking on this because I feel like somebody else going through what I'm going through, and it needs to be said. And I feel like I could be that vessel to help somebody. But I got to come and give y'all the real, real rundown of what's going on. About what I just went through. And how my ex, the Virgo dude, he's crazy. He's sick. He's delusional. And you really have to watch the people you deal with. So, I'm just going to jump right in. So, y'all, if y'all haven't went, go back and watch my videos when I was talking about him. But y'all know I had an ex-boyfriend that I was in, I don't know, if we for like 3 years, and we broke up. He cheated on me, left me for somebody else. All right. So yeah. This is not about him. This is not about a little dude. This is about this psycho. So like I said, when I met him, like I said, when me and my psycho ex, like he been like he's crazy, like he been had a motive to get me. This man was trying to date me when I was like, he used to inbox me when I was with my other ex boyfriend. Like I'm talking about. The man used to live across the street from me and with his baby mama. He used to always inbox me, but I never, you know, I never gave him no play or nothing like that. I didn't. So when he hit me up and me and him started talking and got together, for one, he came when I was in a vulnerable state and I was like breaking up with my ex, I was cutting it out completely with my ex, like, so I was like in my feelings and sad and stuff like that, and he played on my emotions. But when I had forgot, like I haven't seen him in like 2 years, like he had lost a lot of weight, so he don't look like himself. So he ended up, so like I said, like me and him started talking or whatever, and he was adamant about coming to see me. I gave him every excuse to not to come see me, and I finally gave in. Y'all, this man is crazy. Like, was like trying to hit me on the first night. We end up messing around or whatever. You know, I'm not ashamed to say that, but like we messed around twice. Then like the second time we didn't use a condom, and like he didn't even tell me that he ejaculated in me. So he didn't tell me this after until me and him got in a relationship. Like his whole motive from the get-go was to get me pregnant. Like he tried to get me pregnant on purpose. Like he literally used to do like, You, I know it takes two, but like that man could have got up. Like he used to make sure that he did that to me. So once I start to see the red flags about him being crazy and stuff like that, I broke up with him. Not even, we went and broke up maybe like 5 days. Like he was begging to get back with me. And I wasn't going, tried to come, you know, come have sex with me again. I wasn't going. Y'all, I say it wasn't even 5 days. He was in another relationship saying he was in love. You just saying you love me, you want to get back with me, but you in a whole new relationship. That right there let me know. You jump from woman to woman. He's a bomb. Like, he's a bomb. He's a bomb ass nigga. Like, he don't even got a pot to piss in, to be for real. And he feeds off of women. Because the little time I was dealing with him, like, you really didn't do nothing for me. You didn't do nothing for me. You didn't help me. You didn't do nothing. Like, you was leeching off me, trying to anyway. And you, like, when he used to come. Okay, found out about his little girlfriend or whatever. I wasn't tripping. I wasn't mad. I'm thinking, you know, it's over. It's past my life. I did feel a type of way. I'm not going to lie. Because I feel like when I was with him, I genuinely was not doing nothing or talking to nobody. Like, I had cut my ex that I was dealing with. Me and this man still don't talk to this day. I cut our communication off with him. So, I wasn't doing anything. And I just feel like if you just wanted to screw around or something, you could have just said that. Like, don't waste my time. So, December 1st come. December 1st got to leave. I supposed to have my cycle. I missed my cycle. Someone told me to take a pregnancy test. I go take a pregnancy test. It's positive. So I had to reach out to him to let him know that, like, I'm pregnant. Knowing you got a girlfriend, I ain't trying to come to, you know, all that. But, you know, I feel a type of way because I was really stressing that. I was stressed before I even knew I was pregnant. And then I'm like, I was stressing him. He was cool. He was happy. Like, that was his plan. I said, you really hated me, y'all, for my birthday. Yeah, that was the plan. I hope it's a boy. Woo-woo-woo. He checking on me every other day or whatever. Asking me how I'm feeling. This is that and the third. All this type of stuff. When can you find out the gender of the baby so I can start buying stuff with the rule? This is that and the third. I think the man never told his girlfriend about the baby at first. All this that I just went through, like, it was a control thing. Like, he didn't want me to let go. Make a long story short, I ended up losing the baby. I ended up miscarrying. Which I said everything happened for a reason. And I'm thankful because they was thinking that the baby was in my tubes. And they was going to have to go in and get the baby out of my tubes. And I thank God they didn't have to. They just had to clean me out. Because one day I do want to have more kids. My daughter is 7 years old and she asks me for a sibling every day. But now was not the time to get her a sibling. And I was like, God know what he be doing. And he be saving us and sparing us for certain things. So, I had to have my little surgery, my procedure. I went home, but whatever. I went back to work the next day. People was coming up praying for me, telling me I'm okay. Which, I'm good. You know what I'm saying? Like, everything happens for a reason. I didn't reach back out to do. When I was telling him that I was dying, that it was a life or death situation, he did not care. I think he was caring about the baby. I'm like, the baby, I'm losing the baby. He ain't saying, are you okay? He didn't care if I lived or died. He didn't even come. He didn't even come. As a real man, you know you laid down before you got with your little girlfriend. You could have been a man that could have been there. My mama, my homegirl, my cousin was there for me. And then all the people that reached out to me. And everybody that reached out to me, I thank y'all and appreciate y'all that was praying for me. So, after I had my procedure, it was nothing left to talk about. It was nothing else to talk about, right? I didn't text him Friday. He hit me up Saturday, asking me how I'm doing. I'm like, I'm straight. He asked him about the baby, said the baby gone. And I just being real with him. Like, I told him, like, I'm the type of person, I'm real. I just told him I felt like you played with me and you weren't there for me. Like, well, you could have been there for me, like, emotionally. Like, you know, because that was a serious thing. But he didn't care. I apologize. I had to work. And then he had his girlfriend add me on Facebook, quit, like, inboxing me for what I'm asking him. Like, why your girlfriend add me? I don't know what she say. You know why she add me. I said, you must never tell her about me or this baby. Yes, I did. Yes, I did. Make a long story short, he got mad when I said, well, y'all don't got to worry about me no more. It's done. It's over with. Y'all have a good life. That's where he got mad. When he see I want chasing him and trying to be with him, he got mad. And then on the 50 script, oh, can you please stop texting me? Because you ruining my relationship with the woo-woo. Dude, you hit me up talking, asking about me. Oh, he got mad. So like, oh, yeah, that's you acting funny. You real funny because how you acting. You're mad because I'm telling y'all can have a good life. We ain't got nothing else to talk about, baby. The baby, it's over. It's gone. Y'all, this is where shit hit the fan. Why the man was sitting here screenshotting my messages, not saying what he was saying, and sending it to the girl, trying to make it look like I was delusional, like I was still wanting him. One thing you're not going to do is paint me out to be a monster. Because like I said, who moves on in a week if you really love me? I said, you never really love me anyway. But like, that's how I know, like, you're sick. Like, you're sick. He do everything for Facebook. Like, he's just a compulsive liar. Oh, baby. The petty in me, I was so livid, y'all. Because I literally had said I would forget everybody. I was going to leave what happened in 2022. Because we going into a new year. I'm about to be 30. Like, I'm finna, you know, do what I said I was on plan to do before this happened. I literally had said, don't come disturb my peace. Then the girl get the text. I text the girl. She just as delusional as him. So, the petty in me, I had to go live. When I went live and told my side of the story, oh, he hated that. Oh, it went from he ain't sorry about the baby, he cared. Bitch, I'm glad the baby died. And that's why I see why your ex left you. Get out of here. I'm making a video. Close my door. I was like, what? First of all, my ex didn't leave me alone. I left my ex alone. Let's be clear. Second of all, y'all, that man so obsessed with my ex-boyfriend. My other ex-boyfriend, like, at this point, I think he's gay and he wants to be with me. I always bring him up. And I guess because he know, like, I still love him. But I ain't talked to that man in I don't know how long. So, y'all, but yeah, he was like, I got messages I could go live to. You just mad because you want me. And, ooh. Baby, I don't want you. That girl can have you. You don't have a pot to piss in. You don't have a pot to piss in. Y'all, this man, I think he been in prison too. That's another thing. Which I ain't knocking nobody, but y'all, since he been out in January, this nigga done been in like 10 different relationships. And every last one of them don't last but a couple months, if that. You trying to find somebody so they can take care of you. Then I've been found out. Used to be this baby mama. Was whooping her when he lived across the street from me. But you could tell he's abusive. Then he got talking. You said you going. I hit you the first night. Sir, I got all the messages and screenshots. Like, dude, you was begging to come mess with me. It just happened. We grown. That's why I said, I thank God. God knew what he was doing. Like, you're crazy. Now, the man kept calling me and texting me, wanting me to argue. I just blocked him. Like, I was upset because I let him get me out the character and I went live. And I showed my tail a little bit. But, like, don't come disturbing my peace and trying to make me be a monster. I don't care about what you got going on. Because that I told him when about the situation, about the baby. I said I didn't need a child right now. I didn't need a child right now. But your mother, well, you've been trying to do that from the beginning. He mad. He's a narcissist. He's mad because he don't have control. That, he thought, well, oh, I got a baby by her. She always going to be here. No. Then spoke on my daughter, spoke on my other baby daddy. Like, they ain't got nothing to do with it. You're just mad. I said, you're mad. Y'all, I say this to say, be careful who you dealing with. If you see red flags and signs that somebody is a narcissist, they abusive, they control and run. because I never dealt with no crazy stuff like this in my life. Now, I can't make this up. I got all the screenshots and messages. Like, I can't make it up. Even when I broke up with him, he kept on, "You gonna be mad when you found something. I found something. When you see me treat somebody else better than I treated you. You ain't do nothing for me, sir. You ain't do nothing for me. What? You ran my bath water once. You cooked for me twice. What's that? All we did was lay up. That's all you wanted to do with hunt. No. Your priorities ain't even together. All the little money you do, you blow it on weed. Like, come on. But I don't judge nobody because, you know, I've been in a place where I ain't had nothing. But, like, he ain't trying to elevate, do nothing. I got my own house. I go to work. I pay these bills by myself. No child support, no food stamps, no nothing. So, and I've been doing this with. I've been a mama, 7 years? I just told me it ain't my fault that you can't carry a baby more than a month. How stupid are you? I got a 7-year-old. I just didn't carry your child for because you're sick. Y'all, that man tried to say so much stuff to make me mad. I left it at that. And I blocked him, and like, I'm still on my healing journey, and I'm moving on. Now, if he come messing with me, I'm going to have to lay him flat. But he ain't stupid, because he know my brothers, they ain't going for none of that. But y'all continue to keep praying for me. Like, I'm good. Like, I'm in a good headspace. Like, I'm not sad. I'm not depressed. Like I said, like, I'm just going to pick up the pieces, continue to heal, and focus on me and my daughter. Like, I'm trying to figure out where I'm finna go for my 30th birthday. I got 2 months to figure it out. So, yes. So, I'm good. Like, I'm good. We going to leave all toxic BS in 2022. But I'm gonna get up out of here because I cooked me some noodles and I'm hungry. So, peace.